Will you hold the line when every one of them is giving up and giving in? Tell me, in this house of mine, nothing ever comes without a consequence or cost. Tell me, will the stars align? Will heaven step in? Will it save us from our sin? Will it? 'Cause this house of mine stands strong. That's the price you pay. Leave behind your heart and cast away.
The Dalton Gang was a group of outlaws in the American Old West during 1890 and 1892. They were also known as the Dalton Brothers, because three Dalton brothers created the gang.
No, there were three Dalton brothers in the gang: Emmett M. Dalton, born in 1871, Robert Bob Renick Dalton, born in 1869, and Grayton Grant Dalton, born in 1861. A fourth brother, William M. Bill Dalton, born in 1866, was an outlaw as well, and mainly rode with the Wild Bunch.
The gang was good at robbing trains and banks. There were seven members in the Dalton Gang. For a year and a half, the Dalton Gang terrorized the state of Oklahoma. While they were in Oklahoma, they were mainly focusing on train holdups. The gang had more murders than loots under their belts. They had managed to successfully, fight back with the Oklahoma law enforcement, Oklahoma law enforcement was trying to bring them justice, but they fought against them and the Dalton Gang won.
Success in beating the Oklahoma law enforcement made them be overconfident. They used that overconfidence to decide to rob two banks in the hometown of Conville. The banks that they're trying to rob are the First National Bank of Conville and the Condane Banks.
So when the Dalton brothers finally decided that, the day came that they were going to rob the bank, they quietly rode through town. They tied up their horses up on a fence that was in an alleyway near the two banks, and they split up into groups. Bob and Emmett headed for the First National Bank, while Grant Dalton led Dick Broadwell and Bill Powers into the Condon Bank.
Someone recognized one of the gang members as they went into the bank and began quietly spreading the word that the town banks were being robbed. The town people grabbed their guns and surrounded the banks. When the Dalton brothers walked out of the two banks, bullets forced them back into the building. The bullets tried to flee out of the back door of the bank, but the townspeople were there as well.
The information channel will be back after this commercial.
See ya!
Thank you.
In the Condon Bank, a brave cashier had managed to delay Grant, Dalton, Powers, and Broadwell with the classic claim that the vault was on a time lock and couldn't be opened. During this time, the town's people were gathering forces when suddenly a bullet smashed through the bank window and hit Broadwell in the arm. The three men bolted out the door down a back alley.
Like their friends next door, they were immediately shot and killed after coming out of the bank. This time by a local livery stable owner and a barber. After the gun battle was over, the townspeople had killed the Dalton gang, killing every member except for Emmett Dalton. The Daltons took four townspeople to the grave with them. After covering the gun wounds Emmett received, he was tried and sentenced to life in prison.
After 14 years, Emmett Dalton had won parole after he gained the respect as a former Wild West bandit into a position as a screenwriter in Hollywood. After several years of living in California, he died at the age of 66 in 1937. And that was the end of all the Dalton brothers. So we are here on scene at the location where the Dalton brothers were almost completely wiped out. The Dalton gang was wiped out. They didn't last the gunfight right here. Right here is where almost all of the Dalton brothers had died. This is the bank that they attempted to rob. As you can see, it's a little worn down now. It's just great to live in the moment, you know? So we are now at the Oklahoma Federal Prison, and this is where Emmett Dalton was held for 14 years, and then he won his parole and moved on to California. So as you can see, it's pretty locked up. We can't go into the area. We had to stay on the outside, and this is where he got his freedom as well. Then he headed to California and began his Hollywood career as a actor and movie writer. Pointed right here. Okay, never mind. Okay, so it's really hard to see now, but we are just outside of Emmett Dalton's final place of living. It is his old home here in Hollywood. And as you guys probably can't see because it's too dark, but there are people living in there now. So it has still been sold to new people as he has passed.